Whenever I'm looking for a used car for purchase, I usually do an all system scan to identify any trouble codes. And so when this scan on a 2013 RAV4 showed multiple SRS codes despite the airbag light being off, I knew there was something fishy at play. However, with that informed decision, I went ahead to get the car anyway. And here's my plan for restoring the SRS in this RAV4 back to factory state. Now let's get this. These codes that you can see are consistent with an impact to the passenger side of the vehicle. And even though the bodywork was done well, my take is that the sellers have either used resistors to trick the SRS module or they've done some form of bypass to turn off the airbag light. As you can see, the light comes on when you turn on the ignition, but it then disappears when the car comes on. So here's my analysis and plan for this car. The first code B1821, open in side squib right hand circuit, tells me most likely that the front passenger seat airbag deployed. Now this seat has two airbags and I'll know more when I strip off the upholstery. The front passenger seat airbags are going to be replaced, except in the event where it's only one of them that deploys, which can happen. B1831 refers to the passenger side airbag curtain. This has definitely deployed, and just to show you, if I remove this trim piece on the A pillar, you can clearly see that the side airbag curtain is missing, and what we have are just remnants of the airbag material. Just to show you a comparison on the driver's side, with the trim detached, you can clearly see that the side airbag curtain is still in place. So I'm adding that to the list of airbags to procure. B1901, or open in the pre-tensioner squib right hand circuit, also tells me that the passenger on the seat was wearing a seat belt at the time. You can see here when I pull the seat belt repeatedly, there's this metallic noise. And even when I pull it sharply, it's not stopping just like you would expect in a well-functioning seat belt, just as you can see here on the driver's side. B1941 still refers to this front passenger seat belt, but this time it's the aspect of it that applies a selective force when deploying the seat belt. In summary, this passenger seat belt would also need to be either replaced or repaired. These other four codes are just historic variants of the ones that we've already covered, so I'm currently looking at two or three airbags to procure plus the seat belt pre-tensioner. After replacing these parts, I'll then go ahead to clear the crash data and most likely recalibrate the occupant detection system. If this sounds interesting to you, be sure to subscribe so that you follow my progress, and I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.